Here's a spoiler alert for today's episode. People really like the new iPhone. How's it going, everybody? This is Dave LeClaire with MUO Tech Bytes, and it is time to take a look at the biggest tech news stories from the last couple of days. And I don't want to waste your time on a long introduction, so why don't we just jump right into it and look at the news. So kicking things off with our first story today, Microsoft has officially announced Office 2021. And it's coming without a subscription, so you will only have to purchase it one time, and then you will have the app. You can use Word, you can use Excel, you can use all that stuff for one fee instead of having to do a Microsoft Office 365 subscription. Now, the big pitch and the reason that a lot of companies want their users to move towards subscriptions, besides the obvious of getting money every month, is that they offer a longer-term period of updates. It allows them to keep the app current without you having to buy a new one. But for Office 2021, Microsoft is promising 5 years of additional updates and tweaks to the software. As you might expect, Office 2021 is coming to Windows, but it's also coming to Mac OS. It will work on 32-bit and 64-bit systems, and it will even come with OneNote. So you'll kind of get everything you need to get all your work done if you are a Microsoft Office user. You'll get it all from this one piece of software. Unfortunately, Microsoft didn't announce a price for Office 2021 yet. So we do know it's going to be a one-time purchase, but we don't know how much that one-time purchase is going to be. And that'll be really the determining factor as to whether or not it's worth getting Office 2021 or going with the subscription-based Office 365. Because if Office 2021 is like $500 or something like that for an upfront cost, then it would probably make more sense to go with the subscription. But if it's reasonably priced, it might make more sense to go with the one-time purchase depending on your tolerance for subscriptions. Some people hear the word subscription and they immediately cringe. Some people like the idea of paying a smaller amount each month instead of one big amount up front. Either way, hopefully Office 2021 delivers a reasonable price that makes everybody happy. If you own a previous generation Samsung device and you've been sitting on the sidelines thinking, man, I really feel left out in the cold here. I want the new features offered by the S21, but I don't want to go out and buy another phone. Well, you're in luck because Samsung has announced that some of those S21 features are coming to older Galaxy devices through the One UI 3.1 update. The update is coming to Samsung Galaxy S20 series phones, Galaxy Note 20 series phones, the Galaxy Z Fold 2, and the Galaxy Z Flip. So if you own any of those phones, the One UI 3.1 update will start rolling out now, and you should get it at any time. The only thing we don't know is if sub-devices like the Galaxy S20 FE or Fan Edition will get the update. As that's a cheaper version of the phone, it's possible that Samsung may not code an update for that. We'll have to wait and see. Hopefully it does. If you have that phone and you've received the One UI 3.1 update, hit the comment section and let us know. Now, as far as what features you'll get with this update, Samsung is bringing its new enhanced single take feature, which basically uses multiple settings and multiple lenses to take a photo and then help you choose the best one based on the situation. So instead of having to try the long angle and try the telephoto, you could just take one photo and then pick the best one. It's also bringing its cool object eraser tool, which allows you to remove an unwanted item from your photo without needing to spend like hours manipulating it in Photoshop. Instead, it just uses its intelligent AI to remove the object and replace it with an appropriate background. You're also going to get Samsung's Eye Comfort Shield feature, which is basically its blue light reduction. With that, it'll reduce the amount of blue light your phone emits throughout the day, which could help you sleep better. Those are the biggest ones. There's a couple more, such as multi-mic recording and private share, but those are really the big features that are coming. So if you own one of those devices, get ready to have some cool new goodies added to your phone. Obviously, it's not going to turn your phone into an S21. You're not going to get a new processor or a new camera, but you will get some cool new features, and that is always a nice thing. The Chromecast with Google TV has almost every video app under the sun, but there's one that was missing, and that was Apple TV. But now Apple TV is actually coming to the Chromecast with Google TV, so you'll be able to take advantage of it and watch all those Apple TV exclusives right from your Google device. So if you're like me and you receive one of those extended Apple TV Plus trials when you purchased a new iPhone, but you haven't used it because your Chromecast with Google TV doesn't support it, well, you can download the app right now and you can watch all that stuff on Apple TV Plus. Any of the movies or shows from Apple TV Plus that have caught your attention will now be readily available on your Chromecast with Google TV, and that is very exciting. According to data from Ookla and research firm mScience, the most popular 5G phone on the market is the iPhone 12 Pro Max. In the United States, it is the most popular 5G phone in 49 of the 50 states, leaving just one state that said, eh, we're not so big on the iPhone 12 Pro Max. If you're still not sold on the popularity of the iPhone 12 and the iPhone 12 Pro round out number 2 and 3, though the two firms actually disagree on which one is 2 and which one is 3. But either way, the iPhone 12 is definitely the king of 5G phones by a sizable margin. Following the iPhones are the Samsung Galaxy S20 and the Samsung Note 20 series, which Again, not really much of a surprise. Those are two phones that are extremely popular in the Android space, and those are the ones that we would expect to see sitting atop the Android throne. Have you purchased one of the new iPhones, and are you happy with it? Obviously, a lot of people purchase them, but what this doesn't tell us is how much they like the phones. So if you have one of the new iPhone 12s, hit the comment section and let us know your thoughts. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this episode of MUO Tech Bytes is finished. You can turn it off now, but before you do, make sure to subscribe, make sure to like, make sure to do all that good stuff, and make sure to come back for the next episode because I will be here ready and waiting for you. It's not as creepy as it sounds, I promise.